So there's been a lot of talk about artificial or Apple intelligence lately, and I'm certain a lot of it will be utilized in Final Cut Pro to make it better and faster. My friend Matthew O'Brien actually did a full video on that topic. But before it's implemented, I want to go over a few features already included in Final Cut Pro that kind of use artificial intelligence to automatically make your video and audio better. The first feature I want to talk about today is audio analysis. Final Cut Pro can analyze your audio, detect, and automatically fix a number of problems. You can either select this option when importing your media, or you can do it after the fact in the video inspector. Just select your clip in the timeline, go up to the video inspector, and select the audio inspector. Click the magic wand button beside audio analysis. Final Cut Pro will analyze your audio and automatically fix any problems that are severe and flag what it considers moderate. Even when it doesn't detect any problems, you can still use this to enhance your audio. I use the loudness control all the time to normalize my audio. Selecting it automatically boosts the volume in your clip. But it doesn't just turn it up, it actually compresses your audio, so you can boost the quieter parts of your clip without clipping the louder parts. There's two adjustment sliders for loudness, amount and uniformity. The amount slider adjusts the overall loudness or compression of the clip, and the uniformity slider adjusts the dynamic range affected. What I usually do to normalize my audio is leave the amount at 40% and bring up the uniformity slider until my audio is at the level I want. In the past, I've used the audio compressor, the limiter effect, or even a combination of both of these to normalize my audio, but lately, I've just been using this method. It's much easier, and my audio sounds just as good. Feature number two that uses AI to improve your footage is option to balance color. This samples the lightest and darkest areas in your image and removes any color cast from your clip. Final Cut Pro also adjusts the image to increase contrast. Simply clicking this button automatically makes your clip look better. But there's more to this. If you just click the balance color button, Final Cut Pro analyzes the frame your playhead's on and balances your color based on that frame. But if you analyze your clip for balance color, Final Cut Pro will base the correction on your entire clip, not just a single frame. I find I consistently get better results with this method. Just like analyzing audio, you can analyze for balance color when you import your clips or after the fact. Just select your clip in the media browser, right-click on it, and select Analyze and Fix. In the pop-up window, make sure balance color is selected and click OK. Now, when you select balance color, Final Cut Pro will adjust the colors in your clip based on the entire clip, not just one frame. Another use for the balance color tool is fixing the white balance of your clip. Just click the balance color button, go up to the video inspector, and from the method dropdown, select white balance. Use the eyedropper tool to select an area in your clip that should be pure white. Final Cut Pro will use this to adjust the color in your clip for perfect white balance. Number three on the list is voice isolation, and this works amazingly well. Just hang on a sec, I'll show you. Hear that? That's an air conditioner running in the background. I'm going to turn on voice isolation right now. Quite a bit better, isn't it? Okay, let's shut this noisy thing off. To turn on voice isolation, just select your video clip with background noise, and in the audio inspector, select the voice isolation checkbox. Play back your clip and adjust the amount slider until you're happy with the sound. I find anything over 40 or 50% does affect your voice, so only bring this up as little as you need to. Feature number four that utilizes AI or machine learning is object tracking. Just like voice isolation, this works really good on most clips. You can track your clip first, then use the tracking data, or you can take something like a title or an effect and drag and drop it right in the viewer window to track it. Let's grab a title and drag it over our viewer window. As soon as you hover over an object or a face, Final Cut Pro recognizes it and labels it. Let's track our subject's face. Open the tracker dropdown and select what you want to track. For this example, all we want to do is track position, so make sure rotation and scale parameters are deselected. Click the Analyze button to track your clip. Now, this is tracking in real time. It's crazy fast. Once the track is finished, the title moves perfectly with our subject. Number five is Smart Conform. When you have a traditional 16:9 video and you want to convert it to either a vertical or a square format for mobile platforms, you'll probably have to reframe a few clips. First of all, in Final Cut Pro, you don't need to re-edit your project. Just select it in the media browser, right-click on it, and select Duplicate Project As. Select the format you want to switch to, set your video resolution, and before clicking OK, select the Smart Conform checkbox. Click OK. Final Cut Pro analyzes all your clips in your project, figures out the part of the frame that has most action, and reframes your shots to center it. The only downside here is it doesn't track it. So if your subject is in the middle of the frame, then moves to one side, Smart Conform doesn't follow your subject. You have to manually keyframe it. This is one feature I'm confident is coming soon in an update. I'm pretty sure Final Cut Pro for iPad already has it. Now, as I'm recording this video, Final Cut Pro 10.8 isn't out yet. Once it gets released, there's going to be quite a few more tools utilizing AI. I'll make sure to make a follow-up video, and I'll link it here. Until then, watch this one. I'll see you over there.